Hi, this is Matt with Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. Today we're doing a quick video on how to install the software on a Verizon 4G card for the Panasonic Toughbooks. It is the Sierra Wireless MC7750 card. The first thing that I would recommend is checking Device Manager to make sure your card is showing up. You can do that by pressing the Windows key and the Pause Break key to bring up the system properties, which is the page, which is this page here. You can also bring it up by right-clicking on computer and the start button in the start menu, or if you have it on the desktop and click properties, it'll take you to the same space. If you click Device Manager, it'll bring up your Device Manager. If you see the MC7750 drivers here missing, that tells you you have the card physically installed, just the software is not. To get the software, it's directly on Panasonic's website. I found the easiest way to get to the spot on Panasonic's website is to just Google Panasonic drivers, so that's what I'm going to do. There's less steps involved to get to it manually off the Panasonic's website. There's a couple few steps you have to go through to find the right spot. Now, for regular drivers for the Panasonic Toughbooks, you'd want the drivers, downloads, tablets, and support at Panasonic. That's the first link here, is the link you would want. If you're downloading a mobile broadband card software, you would want the other downloads link, which is right here. But just to show you, you can access it from the regular downloads link. I'll show you how. Once you click here, the link to take you here to the driver's download page, you go up here where it says computers and tablets. If you click that, it'll take you back a stage on the Panasonic website where you can choose right here the other downloads category. From there, you click where it says learn more under wireless carrier. That'll take you to the wireless carrier softwares. Depending on which card you're doing determines which category you're looking under. The card we're getting ready to do is the Verizon 4G card. It's Verizon only, so it's going to show up under the Verizon tab. You go down to where it says module MC7750 software for Verizon Wireless, and you download all three of the items underneath of it: the VZ Access Manager, the driver package, and the firmware. You just click on the file and it'll ask you if you want to open or save it. You would just click save. I've already downloaded it in the background prior to the video just to save time. Once you download the file, download all three files, go ahead and open your downloads folder or wherever you saved it to, and it downloads zip files of the programs you need. So you need to extract those files, which I've already done here, just so you know how to extract them. If you already have WinRAR or 7-Zip, or there's several extracting programs out there, you just right click it and then click extract files and tell it where to extract the files to. By default, it will just go to the same folder location. It'll just make a folder name the same thing. So the first step you're going to want to do, now that you've gotten the driver software downloaded, is you want to go to the folder that says driver package on it. You want to run the setup file within. It may take a few minutes for the setup to complete. As you can see, it's popping up saying installing driver software. And if you click on that, it'll bring this page up showing the progress of the drivers being installed. The program's already finished running, which extracted the files it needs from the program to install the drivers. Now Windows just has to finish installing and picking up the drivers, which this window here is showing, the driver software installation page is showing. once the software is all installed, your Verizon 4G card will show up under, if it's done correctly and the card is good, will show up directly under the network adapters, under the ports, under modems, and under USB. So see, as you can see here, it's showing up under modems, it's showing up under network adapters, showing up under ports, and it's showing up under the USB controllers. Now that you have the software installed, you have to go back to your downloads folder and go to the firmware folder, and you need to run the firmware tool. If you don't run the firmware tool, once you have the VZ Access Manager installed, it won't access the card correctly, so make sure you run the firmware. You just click OK once it comes up, and it takes a few moments for the firmware to run, but like I said, you have to do the firmware, or otherwise, once you have the VZ Access Manager installed, it will not pick up and access the card correctly. Now with Verizon, you don't have to have a SIM card on a mobile broadband card if it's a 2 or 3G card, but if it's a 4G card like this card is, you have to have a SIM card. Otherwise, if it's 2 or 3G, you can just call your contact at Verizon, your sales rep at Verizon, and using the IME number and the MEID number of the card, which can be found on the bottom of the computer on a white sticker usually, or on the card itself. If with those numbers, they can usually get your card activated to your account. Where the SIM card goes on your unit depends on which unit you're using. The unit I'm using for this video happens to be a CF31, and the SIM card slot for the CF31 is right underneath the HDMI port. It's in the same compartment that the HDMI port is in. It's just right underneath of it. As you'll notice, part of the way through the firmware update, it's going to start reinstalling the driver for it. That's fine. That's to be expected. That's what it's going to do. That's not going to do anything harmful to your computer or mess up the drivers in any way. Once it's done, it'll say modem's updated successfully. You click OK and go back to your downloads folder and go ahead and open up the VZ Access Manager folder and run the install for the VZ Access Manager. On the first page, you'll click Next. On the second page, you can choose either between full view or minimum view. I would just leave it as the full view, and I would suggest clicking this link here that says create, this check mark here that says create a VZ Access Manager desktop shortcut. Then click Next, Next. Just leave it as typical and then click Next, Install. It'll take a moment and then it'll go ahead and finish installing the software. It's much quicker than running the firmware update. Click Finish. Once that's done, you can close all your open pages. You can open up your VZ Access Manager. There's the typical license agreement. It'll detect your mobile broadband card for the first time having opened it. And at this point, it just takes a moment to come up. It'll configure the device after it detects your card. At this point, once it's done configuring the device, you're all set. You just have to, I'll show you how you would launch the connection. I cannot do that at the moment because I don't have a SIM card in the computer. If you don't have the SIM card, then you cannot connect with this card. You have to have your SIM card inserted. You have to insert the SIM card before you turn the computer on. Otherwise, you just have to restart the computer before it'll allow you to connect to the VZ Access Manager. Okay, so here we go. It's saying SIM is not inserted. Do you wish to continue? It's saying that because I don't have the SIM card inserted. I'm just going to continue just so I can show you where you would go to connect to your card once you have a SIM card inserted that's activated with your account. You'll go to the spot that says Verizon Wireless VZ Access. You'll make sure that's selected. And then you'll go down to where this button that says, right now it's grayed out on my screen, but it should be green on yours. It says Connect WAN. You'll click that button, and it should start connecting to your mobile broadband card, through your mobile broadband card to Verizon. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions or any comments, just let us know. You can give us a call at our toll-free number of 877-202-7788, or you can send us an email to our tech support email of tech_support@bobjohnson.com. Thank you. Have a good day.